Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about manually managing your music and videos on your iOS devices. So a lot of people get frustrated when trying to figure out how to get specific music and movies from their Mac to their iOS device. And the reason for this is because if you use the standard sync settings, you have to set certain pieces of media, certain music albums, certain movies to sync over. And if you want to change what's on there, you basically have to alter these sync settings and sync them again, which is kind of counter to how you're used to using things like the Finder, where you just basically drag and drop a file from one location to another. And you would like to just drag and drop a file from your Mac over to your iOS device. Well, you can do that, but you have to set it up right. So let's look here in iTunes. Here's my music collection, and you can see I've got an iPad connected here. Now I could just click there and go to the iPad settings, but it's going to be a lot easier to do all this if we show sidebar. So I'm going to do view show sidebar, and now I can see my iPad and also little categories here for music and movies. If you don't see those, just open that up like that. So I can see what music's on it, and it's nothing. Now let's look at the iPad itself and look at the summary information. We can see here that I have checked manually manage music and videos. Now this is the key part. If I were to turn that off, then I could go into music. I could sync music and say my entire library or selected playlists, and I could set up exactly what I want to sync to it, like just a few artists. If I want to change what's on there, like add some songs, I have to go to this screen again and I have to customize it. Maybe adding albums, adding genres, adding artists. Maybe I have to add a playlist and then take the songs that I want and actually put them in that playlist so then it syncs to my iPad there. And the same is kind of true for movies. I can sync movies, then I have to select which movies I want to sync. But if I just turn those off and don't have it do the syncing of music and movies, go to Summary and turn on Manually Manage, now I've got something that's going to be a lot easier to deal with. Let me show you. Now all I need to do to put music on here is go to my library here. This is my library on my Mac, and choose a song, any song I want. So I'll choose a song here and I will drag it to the iPad. And you see I can do that. I can't do that if I have manual syncing turned off. But I do that here and it's going to sync to it. And you can see it actually is going to update the files on the iPad right there. It's going to put it right on the iPad. It's not going to even wait for the next sync. And if I go to the iPad under music, you can see right here what songs I have on it. And I can actually select it, hit the delete key, and I can remove it right there. So I can manage it on a song by song basis, pulling one song from my music library in here and deleting them manually. Now the same is true for movies. I can look at movies here, so I have no movies. I can go to movies on my Mac. I can drag this in and it will then add that movie file directly to the iPad, and I can click in here and see that it's been added. So I can see what music and movies I've got, and I can delete them and I can drag and drop new ones there. Now here's something that's pretty cool. I don't even have to have the file in my iTunes library to do this. I can go to the Finder. Here I've got a Finder window with some video in it, and I can drag and drop that video right into the iPad. And it's not going to add it to my iTunes collection. It's just going to add it directly from the Finder to the iPad. And you can see it loading it up there. So it's a way to skip having video files in iTunes in order to get them to your iOS device. And I could do the same thing for music. I could go into the Finder here, there's an MP3 file, and I can drag and drop that directly in here. I can also drag that in here. Notice both places are valid places to drop it, and it will sync the new file directly there without ever adding it to my iTunes library. But perhaps the coolest thing about manually moving files to and from your iPad this way is that you can do it for more than one Mac. So take this situation. You sync your iPhone with your computer, your desktop computer, and you fill it up with music. Then you go on a trip. And while you're on that trip, you realize on your MacBook that you're traveling with, you have some music on there that you like to put on your iPhone so you can listen to it. Well, there'll be no way to sync it over to your iPhone because your iPhone is set to sync music with your desktop computer at home. But if you manually manage music and videos, now you can connect your iPhone to your MacBook, which it's not usually synced with, and you can drag and drop that music onto your iPhone, adding it to what's on your iPhone without erasing all the music that's on your iPhone. So manually managing music and videos has three big advantages. One, you have better fine-tuned control over exactly what media gets onto your iOS device. Two, you can put stuff on there without it first having to be in iTunes. And third, you can then put stuff from another Mac, say your portable Mac as opposed to your desktop Mac, onto the iOS device without having to erase all the media and resync it. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.